December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in week 13. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. First down, here's the run with Cook. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Second down following the run. They run it again with Cook. Room here to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The numbers a week ago for Cook. 14 carries, 77 yards.
After the last game, they have plenty of reason to be confident in their running game. And even though they're facing a top 10 defense, they're not going to shy away from doing what they do best. Make them adjust to them. Make them stop what they do before they go to any type of a changeup.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game, but when you have good team defense, and we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete. Second down, Cook. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon.
False start, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. And here we go on first and goal. And here is motion again. And that's going to be 2 in a row.
False start, offense.
So that'll back him up 5. The penalty, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL, so do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota.
Foster offense.
And that'll set him back 5. Second down, Bradford. And on the left side. sideline. He caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
When we talk with people about what we think the most important quality for an NFL quarterback to possess, what do people usually say?
Arm strength. And he showed the arm strength there.
Yeah, pretty good bullet pass he threw, but he wasn't accurate, was he?
No.
Listen, you like mobility, but accuracy, first and foremost, is what a quarterback needs. He didn't possess it on that play.
And it's caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A big play, but still not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. An update from Denver. The Broncos have taken the early lead. Trevor Siemian, a first quarter touchdown pass in that one. To return, this is Eddie Jackson. Start this drive in the air. And his throw here is incomplete. And on second and 10 now.
Here we go now.
Back to throw here. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom, nine.
They'll set up to throw. And that is incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
Bradford hands to Cook on the draw, and they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. From the gun, Bradford. And Rudolph has it left side. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
Watch it now, Barney. Here we go. Green, 39. Over.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Vikings will take over here first and 10. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Malik McDowell forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Bradford throwing the out route incomplete. It's Tucker, and he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for him. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up fourth down. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that will hit and continue on out of bounds. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field.
This is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
They needed some breathing room. He gave it to them. 11 yards and a first down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job here to force an incompletion.
He'll drop to throw. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Akeem Ayers. And he will take this down to the 10-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
They'll run with Cook. And he's able to find some room as they get him down after a good run. A good pickup there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to the booth right after this. Reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner.
They'll run for it with Cook. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Calling a gain of 2 as they're knocking on the door now. 3rd and goal.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, trying his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
Third and goal, Bradford. And that'll be caught by Diggs for a Minnesota touchdown. Stephon Diggs, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about three steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a two-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Not too many teams will use a first-round pick on a tight end, so you know that when one does, he's got to be pretty darn special.
A small example of why they took him in the first round there. Nice little catch and run to get the good yardage.
Man open left side, it's Williams. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A gain of six there on first. The Bears moving hastily in the hurry-up offense. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Corn Elder.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Following the interception, Bradford over the middle here to Rudolph. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now Bradford on second down. Now they go screen. It's complete. And here he'll get it down to the seven. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. First down and goal to go from the seven. Working out of the gun, Bradford. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Now a second down throw for Bradford. And Rudolph has got it. The big tight end for a Viking touchdown. Kyle Rudolph, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He and his team, they have had a rough go of it here in this first half. Maybe time for him to put his foot down here in the second quarter.
Put his foot down and become a little more accurate throwing the football. He's already thrown two interceptions. He's trying to find a way to equal things out. And instead of it going to the opponents, get it to his own receivers and find the end zone.
Yeah, you mentioned those two picks. No touchdown passes yet either. He was looking for John Ross that time. That'll bring up second down.
and attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the He's got daylight. Throw left side, complete to Ross. Touchdown, Chicago. A big play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bears are able to show off their quick strike ability. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't it?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
Well, now he's looking just to add to his totals.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Again, it's Cook. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. Past the 20. And they will finally catch him, but not before he gets it to the 11. We have hit. We now proceed to the start of the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken near the 13.
It's the third quarter, and they're down on the scoreboard. And while no one wants to hit the panic button just yet, points are a necessity on this drive. What a great way to get set up.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
They'll look to throw, and he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Danielle Hunter in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
How about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
And there's a nice stop for the defense. They've had a tough time containing this guy all game long, but maybe they can build a little bit off of that play, a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. Yeah, every now and then you can actually tackle that guy.
Here's Bradford. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Ross on the return. Call that a 46-yard punt, though they did get 9 back on the return. And the Bears take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to...
The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Daniil Hunter, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
That's his second sack of the game, and the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive lineman across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
Looking downfield, and that's caught right side. He's got his man. A good pickup there at 22. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they?
Yeah,
when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
All right, now look at 56. Look at 56.
Back to throw now on first down. And this is caught at the 8. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Again, he'll drop the throw. And this one's incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me that option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Let's go!
He'll drop the throw. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now out. Comes Minnesota. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was pump the football because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them. This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Looking to throw on second down. Bradford. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell him, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
Now here's Ross. Oh, and he's taken down here by his face mask by the looks of it. And a penalty flag is going to give a much better starting position.
Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And again, this time to the tailback. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. On third and short, going with a tight end. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. They'll set up a throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 22. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. And I'm going to keep firing.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Oh, pardon me. That play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him through. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. So from three scores down, these guys have fought all the way back to grab the lead, and I'll just tell people what happened when they went up three scores. I wrote on your paper two words, game over, and now I'm eating those words. I was wrong.
Little salt, little pepper, yeah, goes down pretty easily.
I will admit when I make a mistake.
Well, it looked like it was going that way. This is one of those paging Frank Reich moments, and I can't believe I just brought that up because Frank Reich at Maryland in college did it to my Tennessee Volunteers, and that was a big reason why my team lost.
Sounds like he still harbors some pain from that game.
You know, we still got a little time to work it out with the doctor.
This is taken at the three. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And the Vikings now heading on to the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense, right?
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Let's go! They'll come out throwing here on first down. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And despite the good footwork, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. Only three there on the screen. It's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
All right, here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. A first carry for the Clemson man, Wayne Gallman. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. That good for 19 and a first down. And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. Going to give this time to the tailback. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and two now. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So the Bears with a football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking to throw. Hard throw, incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. A great effort there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Bears will add on to their lead. And that one pushes the lead up to 11. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. Oh, now he bowls him over. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pickup there, a 22. Bradford now to throw on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. Bradford saying, let's go, fellas, urging his guys to get set. Second down, Bradford. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Again, it's Bradford. It's caught by Treadwell. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 11 yards for number 11.
First down, Bradford. Over the middle, complete. It's George. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota.
Foster, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. So after the mistake by the offense, it cost him 5 yards, and now first and 15. To the air again with Bradford. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Hodges. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as he'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. They'll throw again. Bradford. His throw caught right around the six. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. So the offense has it. 6 yard line. First and goal. Bradford again. His pass caught at the four. He'll get only two there, and it's second and goal.
When you see zone defense and you know you got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota.
Foster, offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. To throw on second down. Bradford out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. And now here comes their final timeout as they take it with 8 ticks remaining. Bradford from the gun on third down. And this is caught. So it's a late touchdown, but maybe too late. Still a little time left on the clock, however.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive.
And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. They're in the fourth quarter in Denver. And it was the Patriots that wound up winners in that one. Christian McCaffrey closing in on 100 yards on the ground. He's at 98. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. And this is going to be recovered by the hand seam. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Looking for White on the deep ball. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. Well, I know at points in this one you wanted to close your eyes.